Welcome back to Block TV. This is Block Hits. We round up all the top headlines from around the cryptosphere. Forbes reports how Senator Mitt Romney considers action as a nation on cryptocurrency threat to Homeland Security. Cointelegraph reports how McCree Zahn claims he was removed from Bitmain without his consent. Decrypt reports how Bitfinex and Kim.com are calling off the KimCoin token sale due to regulatory concerns. And CCN reports that a crypto heist involving thieves penetrating a Bitcoin ATM warehouse steals 85 Bitcoin ATMs. And lastly, CoinDesk reports how first-time Bitcoin buyers doubled in Square's Q3 report. Well, starting us off, Forbes reports that during an U.S. Senate committee hearing on the Homeland Security and Governmental Affairs, former presidential candidate and current Senator Mitt Romney decided to spread some FUD and asked leaders from the FBI, Homeland Security, and the National Counterterrorism Center if the U.S. should be worried about and take action against cryptocurrencies. Now, FBI Director Wray immediately responded that cryptocurrencies are a significant problem that will get bigger and bigger. He continued to explain how crypto is used by terrorists amid a growing trend of bad actors using new technologies to transact anonymously. Now, Director Wray did note, however, that they do have various tools to track non-privacy coins like Bitcoin. Cointelegraph reports that McCree Ketuan Zahn, the co-founder of Bitmain, aims to take legal action against the world's largest producer of Bitcoin mining equipment after he claims he was removed from his position at the company without his consent. Now, it's not clear what legal backing he has here, as removal without one's consent is also known as being fired. At the time of his termination, Zahn was the largest stakeholder in the company, but it seems like co-founder and chairman of the board, Jihan Wu, was able to wrangle together a majority of the stakeholders on his side against Zahn. Zahn dramatized the coup and made clear his intention to fight, saying, "I didn't realize until then that those scenes in TV shows where you get stabbed in the back by those partners you trusted and brothers you fought together with can really happen in real life. Bitmain is our child. I will fight for her till the end with legal weapons. I won't allow those who want to plot against Bitmain to succeed. If someone wants a war, we'll give them one." Well, this is shaping up to be an ugly power struggle for one of the biggest companies in the cryptosphere. Make sure to stay tuned at Block TV as this story develops. Well, Decrypt reports that Bitfinex crypto exchange and Kim.com, the notorious founder of the file sharing website Mega Upload, are canceling their plans to launch a Kim token. Bitfinex was already facing a fraud investigation by the New York State Attorney General, has decided to squash the Kim coin sale due to regulatory uncertainty. Now, they did mention that the Kim platform, which the coin would be used on, is still on track. The Kim platform aims to allow users to monetize files stored on their computer. So, for instance, you upload a stolen copy of a movie to the platform and charge viewers to access it. Now, Kim.com himself went to prison for hosting stolen content on his website, Mega Upload. He promises that this new platform will circumvent this issue by designing it in a way where the administrators won't be able to know the content of the uploaded files, thus shielding them from legal responsibility. Whether the courts buy this innocence by ignorance claim remains to be seen. Well, in the wildest story you will hear today, CCN reports that a gang of five thieves in Malaysia pulled off what can be called a bank heist in the new crypto world we live in. Four men and one woman rented a location next door to a warehouse where Bitcoin ATMs were being stored. Now, using specialized drilling equipment in the cover of the night, they tunneled their way into the warehouse and stole 85 Bitcoin ATMs. Now, police claimed that the goal of the thieves was to then utilize the ATMs themselves, as the stored ATMs didn't contain any cash, and of course, there is no crypto actually stored inside the ATMs to steal. Unfortunately for the daring thieves, it seems this is where their cleverness ended. The police have already arrested five suspects, but the story does make you think, with the new world of digital currencies on the horizon, what will bank heists of the future look like? And lastly, CoinDesk reports that the Square Cash App, the number one financial app on the Apple Store, processed $148 million in Bitcoin sales in the third quarter of 2019 alone. Now, the company, founded by Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey, has quickly turned into the go-to place for crypto onboarding for American customers. Their earnings report showed how first-time Bitcoin buyers doubled from quarter to quarter, with the company predicting even further growth in the fourth quarter. This is bullish news for Bitcoin, showing the strong interest, especially among retail investors, even post-2017 boom. Well, that was Blockheads. Stay current, stay informed, and stay tuned at BlockTV.com.
For more news and updates, follow us on Twitter.